Hey scoundrels, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. If you want to be a scoundrel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. I've got a really interesting video today. I know it's something that people have heavily requested. I've seen people talking about it on the Eve Echoes Reddit. We're going to talk about fitting a Caracal, and we're going to be talking about some factors that affect missile damage. We'll also be talking about the different types of missile launcher that you have available, and then some tips and tricks to conquer a tier 6 or better anomaly, depending on how confident you're feeling. And then we're also going to show you a little clip of me doing a tier 6 anomaly and a Caracal trainer by myself. What I would say is that tier 5 and tier 6 should be comfortable for you if you're playing those particular encounters right in a Caracal trainer. Once you get into a Caracal or a Caracal Navy issue, you should be able to go up to like 5s, 7s and 8s. But right now in a Caracal trainer, soloing a tier 5 and a tier 6 should be about the extent of your prowess, unless you have loads of ISK and you're able to kit your Caracal trainer out with ridiculously expensive equipment, which I would definitely not recommend. First of all, let's talk about the fitting on my Caracal. So, 132 DPS. I do not have a drone right now. If I was going to get a drone, I would either get a kinetic or a thermal damage drone. It really doesn't matter, but I like to get a bit of balance damage because my missiles are also balance damage, so you might as well just get something that goes in between. But yeah, I would have a drone in there, like a medium MK5 or a medium MK3, depending on what you can afford. I haven't been able to afford one yet. Also not particularly interested in kitting out my trainer Caracal with ridiculously expensive equipment, even though I can move it over to a normal Caracal, just because I don't really see the point. In terms of missile launchers, you can have the MK5 normal missile launcher, or you could have an MK5 Rapid. What I'm going to talk about to you is I'm going to talk about the MK5 normal first, okay? So the MK5 normal, it has a range of, or base range of 28, but that can be expanded with rigs and also missile skills. It has a damage or DPS, a base DPS of 25, explosion velocity of 81, an explosion radius of 140, and a reload time of 10 seconds. So essentially, you'll be able to fire them every 10 seconds. What does explosion velocity and explosion radius mean? When we're talking about damage from these missiles, well, the smaller number of these two, so the higher the explosion velocity and the smaller the explosion radius, the better this missile is at dealing with smaller ships like destroyers and frigates. Medium missile launchers will not deal the full damage to frigates and destroyers, but they will be good versus the likes of cruisers, battle cruisers, and battleships. The medium missile launcher is somewhere in between torpedoes and the rapid missile launchers. The reason I like medium missiles is because they are a little bit more versatile than the rapids, because rapids, I'll talk about in a moment, have some drawbacks despite being much better at dealing with frigates and much better at dealing with destroyers. It also has an activation time of 12 seconds, which means that the missile will be in flight for 12 seconds before it explodes, which is where rigs like missile velocity come into account. So let's talk about, I've got an MK7 one here, so we'll just use the MK7 one as an example. What about medium rapid missile launchers? Well, their activation time is half, so they will not go as far. They have a much shorter range. They have a much higher explosion velocity and a much smaller explosion radius with a reload time of 35 seconds. Well, what does this mean? Rapid missile launchers fire light missiles, which are better versus frigates and destroyers, ships. What I would say about these particular weapons is they are not as good, I would say, as being flexible, and they're also not particularly good at using to kite, because you have to get a little bit closer into the range of rats to actually be able to use these particular weapons. That is why I personally prefer MK5 mediums, because they have a longer range, you're much safer, it will take you a little bit more time to kill frigates and destroyers, but we're going to talk about that because there are things that you can do to make these missiles slightly better against the smaller ships. But that is why I prefer medium missile launchers over the rapids, even though rapids do more DPS, because rapids are shorter range, you need to be able to be much more effective at dealing with your cooldown timers and understanding where you are in relation to the rats and make sure you're keeping out of range while things are cooling down. And medium missile launchers are just a little bit more flexible in that regard. If you mess up some targeting and you accidentally fire a volley of rapid lights at the wrong target, you're going to get punished for it. You get less punished for doing that with medium missiles. So they're just a bit better overall, in my opinion. In terms of mid-slots, let's talk about this. Mid-slots, there aren't many good mid-slots for Caracals. What I would say is that the Stasis Webify and the Nosferatu are going to be your best friends. The reason being is they're only ever going to be used when something gets in range of you. Usually that's going to be a frigate or a quick destroyer. You'll Stasis Webifier it and you'll Nosferatu it, and you'll slow it down, make it easier to kill, and you'll steal a bit of capacitor. Those two are the only two things that I think are relevant here, and you won't be using them 95% of the time when you're trying to rat and PvE effectively with your Caracal. Low slot enhancements. Well, this is a little bit up for debate, and it really depends on how you want to play the anomalies. I think a shield booster is a good failsafe card. Some people like to run without shield boosters, but I think if you don't run a shield booster and you mess up, you're going to get punished for it. So I like to have a shield booster because it's a get-out-of-jail-free card. Afterburner. I like to orbit kite, which means I like to use the afterburner to increase my velocity, meaning I can maintain orbit more effectively versus the targets. It also helps me collect loot after I've cleared waves a little bit quicker than if I didn't have one, which is why I like an afterburner. The other thing to consider here is you could run two ballistic missile control systems. Definitely run one. One is absolutely like awesome. You definitely want one. But you could potentially run two over the afterburner because it just will increase your damage overall. But I personally prefer the setup that I've got because I think it's a bit more flexible and it allows me to do more things. In terms of rigs, I don't currently run any defensive rigs because I'm not getting hit much. If I was going into a missile ratting pack like the Angel Cartels or the Garistas, I might run some like generic shield rigs, which will help prevent against explosive damage or whatever. But honestly, for the most part, you just need to see what type of damage that the NPCs are dealing that you're going up against and try and rig defensively for those. But otherwise, don't worry about it. I haven't needed them to do tier 6s effectively. When it comes to offensive rigs, I would thoroughly recommend you get a Rigor Catalyst. The reason I recommend getting a Rigor Catalyst is because it's going to decrease the explosion radius of your medium missiles, making them more effective against smaller and faster moving targets. Well, just smaller. Actually, faster moving is to do with explosion velocity, but we won't talk about that. The second I can recommend is a Hydraulic Bay Thruster prototype. This is going to allow your missiles to travel further in the time frame that they have. And for medium missiles, that's a really good thing because that essentially gives you 12 seconds where they're going to travel a little bit quicker. I'm currently using the prototype meta level 01. I will replace this eventually when I get to my next Caracal, but it's just giving me a little bit extra range, and these will increase your effective range of your missiles upwards of 35 to 40 kilometers with the right skills. When you're at a 40 kilometer range, almost nothing else is going to hit you, which is why I have chosen these particular rigs. So that's a little bit of an explanation behind rigging, how missile damage is calculated, your weapon choices, your low slots and your mid slots enhancements. Let's have a little bit of a discussion about tips and tricks when dealing with anomalies, and then I'll also show you how I went into an anomaly and did an entire tier 6 without having to warp out using orbit kiting. Something that I forgot to talk about, by the way, before you might wonder why Rupert's just appeared. You'll see in a moment. He woke up when I was doing the video. I actually recorded this bit last because I forgot about it. Skills, obviously really important. Well, because we are driving a cruiser, we want to have cruiser command and eventually advanced cruiser command as well. So you want to be training cruiser command, advanced cruiser command if you have access to it. Expert would be some way off for most of you. Afterburner, I've got afterburner there, and I'll be going to advanced afterburner as and when I can. Shield operation and advanced shield operation. The Caracal is a shield tank, so you want to use shield tanking items. Now, shield hardening is not necessary because you probably don't have a low slot available for it, but shield operation, definitely so. Shield operation and advanced shield operation are very good at keeping your defenses in a good place when you're playing the Caracal. When it comes to engineering, cruiser engineering and advanced cruiser engineering, often very good. Target management and advanced target management, I would recommend training as well. Those are two very important systems. And then when it comes to missiles, these are obviously the most important for damage output. You want medium missile torpedo operation, as well as advanced medium missile torpedo operation. And then you want, eventually, when you're tech 6, you're going to want to get advanced medium missile and torpedo upgrade. Those are the really important skills that you need when you're playing a missile boat, especially in the Caracal, because they will help you out significantly. And Rupert's made some very nice noises all the way through this, so thank you, Rupert. So my son woke up as I was recording this, and so he got a bit grumpy and he needed to have a cuddle. You needed to have a cuddle, didn't you? So you smell a little bit. Maybe I'll have a look at that in a moment. So what I'm going to talk about is a little bit in terms of tips and tricks on how to approach anomalies with a Caracal, okay? First of all, the first thing I'd always recommend that you do is find out what your effective range is, and you can find out what your effective range is by hovering on your missile launcher here. I should be able to... Here we go, yeah. So I can find out that my currently effective range is 35 kilometers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to set orbit, and I'm going to set my orbit to... I like to set it just a little bit below... I will set my orbit to 33 kilometers, but that's just because it gives me a little bit of wiggle room when it comes to finding the correct orbit, okay? What that means is that every time I click orbit on a ship, so if I wanted to orbit this guy, I would naturally go and orbit them at 33 kilometers, which is my effective range, and it means you won't have to manually set your orbit range every time you decide to orbit a ship, which is really important when you're trying to orbit kite because it just makes everything a lot easier. The other thing that you might want to do... And I don't think Jitter has actually got any cosmic anomalies. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump to another system where there could be some cosmic anomalies. So give me 1 second. So what you're going to want to do when you're approaching anomalies to actually... Oh, come on, sweetheart. What you want to do when you're approaching anomalies to actually fight them as a missile ship... Should we try again in a moment? Okay, guys, there are some tips and tricks when it comes to approaching anomalies that you're going to want to use, okay? So okay, sweetheart, that's fine. Come on. Do you want to watch? Oh, you're so upset, aren't you? Okay, look, ready? What we're going to do is we're going to select this scout anomaly, and because we're a missile ship, we're going to warp in around our range, which means that when we approach there and there are going to be enemies to shoot with our missiles, they will be at range from us, and we should be able to then lock them and orbit them at the range that we want to. Now, in the video, you're going to see me do something called juggle orbiting, which is essentially a term that I completely made up. But what you do is you're going to lock everything to target the first ship that you want to take out. I usually like to take out the frigates first because they're the ones that approach me the quickest. And you're going to orbit the ship that is closest to you at all times, trying to maintain a distance from the closest ship, allowing you to maintain orbit. Now, that should be enough, and you're going to see me do it in just a moment in the example T6 anomaly that I cover. But if you are ever in danger, what you need to do is find a station and... Yes, you need to do that. Find a station and go, which basically means approach. And you're going to want to approach that station. If you're orbiting and you kind of feel like you're getting to a point where you're taking a lot of damage, I usually, when I'm getting to around 20% or 25% shields, that's when I'm thinking about chickening out. I will then align, pop my afterburner, and then when I need to, I will then just hit warp or dock. If you're in not...
That's okay.
No, it's bad. It's sad times, isn't it? It's sad times when you get take damage and the rats nearly kill you, isn't it? And then if you click dock, if you're in low sec or null sec, it'll be much safer, of course. Obviously, if you're in low sec or null sec, there is a risk of you getting blown up by pirates. But yeah, if you click dock, that'll get you into the station ASAP. You should be able to reset and head back to the anomaly or whatever you were doing and do the same thing. So we're going to jump into an example of me doing this, and hopefully that will be good enough to allow you guys to kind of do it yourself. So yeah, enjoy. I like to aim for between 40 and 50 kilometers, but that's going to give me usually a bit of time to get into an orbit and then start to approach the anomaly from range, or I'm going to have my advantages with my missiles. My medium missiles have got a 35 kilometer range. I can boost that with rigs when I get back and have some money to buy some. So I'll be able to boost that with rigs, and I should be able to very easily tackle these anomalies. So what I'll do is warp in at 40 kilometers so that I maintain my range on the majority of these targets. Okay, so I've come in and I'm about 50 kilometers range. So I'm going to have to approach, and I want to orbit this guy at 35 kilometers, and I'm going to lock. Rather orbit this guy. So I need to set my orbit. Set my orbit at 35, and this should be fine now. So as soon as I get into range, I want to take out the frigates first. They're the hardest to take out, but they're also they're the easiest to take out. I'm actually going to pop my shield booster for just a little bit here. But also just removing a frigate from the engagement means my DPS, or I'm going to cut the DPS of the enemy wave by a significant amount. I'm going to pop my afterburner here. And I should be getting into range of this guy pretty soon, so I'm going to start firing my missiles. And what I want to do is just pop my afterburner in orbit and continue to cycle round and essentially fire off my missiles. So I want to pop my afterburner in orbit, maintain orbit on these guys, try and keep my range on them. My afterburner will make me slightly harder to hit, so I'm just going to keep my my afterburner going. It's pretty good. Shouldn't drop too far down below 55% capacitor right here, and I shouldn't take too much damage to shields either, because I should have a pretty significant range advantage. I'll only use my ballistic control system when I absolutely need to. And again, Energy Nosferatu is purely about if a frigate gets close to me, I'm going to use my Energy Nosferatu to try and maintain some of my capacitor. But I shouldn't drop too far down below 50%. And again, I'm just being a little bit harder to hit because I've popped my afterburner. I'm maintaining orbit range. And again, going to orbit. Now, what I would suggest with loot, because you want to maintain range, do not loot until you have finished the encounter. So do not loot until you finish the encounter. And again, I'm going to keep my orbit range on this guy. I'm going to make it a bit more difficult. I'm going to keep tagging or keeping an eye on who's getting close to me. Should be able to take this guy. I actually haven't, for some reason, haven't hit this guy yet. I'm actually going to orbit this chap because he's getting closer to me now. So I am going to stop attacking him. I'm now going to orbit this guy. And again, my shields aren't taking too much damage right now, and I still have my shield booster if I absolutely need it. I'm just trying to maintain range on everybody in this engagement, and again, using the afterburner to keep that maintained range, keeping my distance from the enemies, and orbiting around the closest target that gets to me. If anybody starts to close distance on me, I want to make sure I can build a bit of distance between myself and my target. And as you can see here, I'm just going to start bursting through these guys with relative ease. Taking a little bit of damage to the shield, but again, not too much damage. And because I'm maintaining range, it should never be an issue for me to warp out to a specific location. I'm actually going to stop the afterburner here. I'm going to build up a bit of capacitor. I would like to start popping my shield booster just a little bit to pop some shield back here. And again, I'm now just getting through this guy's shields. These are cruisers, so it's just a little bit more difficult, but we should get there. Once I get some riggings and my missile skills get upgraded, this will be much easier, and I'll start to take these through pretty quickly. But I should be able to clear an anomaly like this sort of in 20 minutes, something like that. Again, just going to keep casually popping my shield burster. One of the things that you could consider dropping a low slot for, so you could drop maybe your ballistic missile control system, is for a capacitor battery, if you feel like you're using a lot of capacitor for defensive reasons. You shouldn't need to a lot of the time. To be honest with you, you should be able to just maintain range whenever you can. I'm also in a Caracal trainer, so once I get into a proper Caracal, I'll have a big defensive boost and also capacitor boost. But because I'm in a Caracal trainer right now, I'm obviously in the worst version possible of the Caracal. Okay. Again, I'm just kind of dropping lock. You can see that they're locking me and unlocking me right now. I'm still at 50% shields too. I'm not really threatened in this current point in time. I'm building some capacitor back up so I can actually use my shield booster again. But I'm not too fussed about the current state of my shields. Like 50% shields is like loads of HP left. We've got loads of HP left. Ah, yeah, these guys are the hull tanks. These guys are very difficult to kill. Especially when you get down to hull, it takes a lot longer. You can see, like, I'm basically tickling the hull every time I actually land a missile barrage on him. What I'm probably going to do to save you guys the pain is skip through some of these waves until the end. I'm going to keep doing the same thing over and over again. Going to keep maintaining orbit range on the targets, bursting down the smaller targets all the way up to the larger targets. But as you can see, it's going to take me a little while to get through the hull of these cruisers. And I think the... there was a catalyst that I haven't killed. The destroyer probably would have been quicker. I actually, for some reason, thought that was a battle cruiser. So I need to get these cruisers down, and once these cruisers are down, I should be much easier to deal with. So I decided to speed the next part of the video up because essentially this took a lot longer than I thought it was going to take. It essentially took about 40 minutes to clear a tier 6 anomaly. It is perfectly possible. These were actually pretty difficult rats for me to do on a missile boat. They are very, very armor heavy and very hull heavy, which means especially some of the smaller ships takes a little bit of time for me to do when I'm on my Caracal. But as you can see, I can quite literally AFK versus certain aspects of these fights. We can just hit that orbit range. We pop our missiles, we pop our ballistic control system, and we essentially just continue to batter down the waves however long it takes. And this is what essentially what you want to do when you're solo in these missions. You want to make sure you're maintaining orbit and maintaining range, especially on the closest target to you. Often the way I work is I try and take out the frigates first, then the destroyers, then the cruisers, and the battle cruisers. What I would say as an addition to this is that if something is closing the gap on you, you always want to try and orbit yourself around the thing that gets closest to you. So I'll often switch fire to the target that is closest to me or the fastest ship, because this is going to allow me to more effectively clear the anomaly whilst maintaining HP. As you can see, I'm taking a small or minimal amount of shield damage. This tactic would maybe not be so effective if you are dealing with, for instance, Garistas, maybe, who use missiles, or maybe Angel Cartel, who sometimes use missiles themselves as well. So sometimes, you know, if you're going up against other missile-type rats, you might find that this range tactic doesn't always work. But against the autocannon-type rats, or blasters, or shorter-range lasers or railguns, you are going to be able to outrange, for the most part, your enemies. And you can see here that I'm very rarely dropping to a low capacitor or low shield value. I'm maintaining about 50% capacitor. And I have the Stasis Web of Fire and the Nosferatu for if anything does close the distance. And you can see this had quite a few waves in it. The only one of the drawbacks of being so far away is that you often spread the loot out pretty significantly across the end of the anomaly. So it will take you a while to collect loot, especially if you're kiting these ships, you know, for kilometers and kilometers along, throughout the space. So it might take you a little while longer to actually collect the loot, which is actually why I do like to have the afterburner, by the way. I talked about in the earlier start of the video, there is maybe a argument to say that you don't need the afterburner and you could actually just run with a shield booster, or you don't need the shield booster and you run with two ballistic control systems. But for me personally, I just like the survivability of the shield booster. I like the afterburner for both maintaining a good orbit speed, but also getting the loot afterwards. And then obviously just having the ballistic control system is a must when it comes to dealing with missiles. And as you can see, we have worked our way through this anomaly without actually having to warp out. We've maintained range on all of the tier 6 rats, and we are able to pretty much do it effectively like that. And this can probably be done for tier 7, maybe, but especially in a Caracal trainer, it will be a little bit harder because obviously your damage output is going to be lower. And because everyone is tech level 5 right now, you won't have tech level 7 missiles. And you might not have access to the uniquely named missiles. But as you can see, we got through this anomaly, we made a decent amount of money from it, and then we're able to afterwards go and loot all of the wrecks, which we can then go sell on the market. And again, you know, depending on how much you want to sell for, you know, something like this can make you maybe 1 to 3 million, depending on your loot. Maybe more if you sort of get some particularly good loot. And especially if you're doing it alongside encounters, you can make a significant amount of more money as well. When it comes to like dealing with specific anomalies, like small anomalies or medium anomalies, you might be able to clear these out much quicker. But it is a good way to solo farm, and this is how I've been solo farming high value encounters from 750k upwards to 1.5 million. And then also dealing with ratting in general, getting bounties. So that's how my Caracal was set up. That is how I solo missions, maintaining orbit range on the targets and just basically volleying them down with missile after missile and with the setup that I've got. When I get a medium drone, my DPS should go up a little bit. I'm actually training drone skills to make sure that my DPS is good enough with a drone. But you add a drone into the mix, you're going to have a little bit extra to deal with ships that come closer to you. And I also just want to show you at the end here, I'm going to show you a little bit of footage from another encounter that I did with my friends. Three of us in our destroyers, we did a 5 million encounter, and it was relatively easy as well. So we're going to focus on that in just a moment. So yeah, just to say goodbye and thank you for watching, I just wanted to show you the end of my 5 million ISK encounter. It was an Amar storyline mission end. Did get a 25% corp tax on it, so unfortunately I wasn't able to make actual 5 million, but I made a decent amount from it. And then we also got a load of storyline loot, including two medium energy Nosferatus, which sell for a decent amount. So I'm actually going to be working very quickly towards a fully equipped Caracal. And then once I'm in a fully equipped Caracal, I should be in a good position to be more or be more efficient on my ratting. When I get there, I'll make a video about it and show you guys. But in the meantime, enjoy, if you're in a missile boat Caracal, enjoy trying to solo some more of the higher tier anomalies. And yeah, good luck.